So we are standing up a drive-up, a scheduled drive-up testing location for COVID-19 so that patients or those that have concerns about their potential risk or think they might have COVID-19 can do an online screening via telemedicine using their smartphone and an app that they can download. If they are determined to by the physician or APP to be positive, then they can schedule a time with us to come in and get tested. They drive up in their car and can undergo the testing process without getting out of their car. Sure, so again, as an academic medical center, we're very fortunate that we have some of the world's experts in some of this type of testing. And our genomics and esoteric molecular testing lab, or what we call the GEM lab, is a group of experts that essentially specialize in doing unique testing. And we do that for cancer, we do that for some other modalities. We simply had them refocus, and actually at their own initiative, they refocused on this effort. And I can't say enough about Dr. Coley and his team, as well as Dr. Allison McMullen, Dr. Brandy Gonzalez, our entire microbiology team, and all of our lab staff and personnel who've been working around the clock to develop this technology and to be able to do that. One of the reasons we're using video technology is because it allows us to be more sensitive. So I can pick up on clues when I'm evaluating a patient via telemedicine that you might miss on a chat or an email or just a telephone call. So we think that we're pretty confident about the ability to pick up on, for example, patients that may be in more distress, and we would divert those patients immediately when we evaluate them. In the event that someone shows up, we have healthcare professionals on site that can get the patient to the right place at the right time. Sure, so we're following the CDC guidelines. The fact that we have people doing screening while the patient is in their car or the person being tested is in their car is an advantage because that keeps them away from everyone else. The car essentially provides some isolation, okay? So our personnel will be in proper personal protective equipment as recommended by the CDC to perform the test. So Augusta University is underwriting this effort right now, but we're hopeful that the state will support us in this effort as it is vital to the citizens of Georgia. We believe in supporting the community and supporting the state, and we're just trying to do the right thing for our patients, and that's what we're trying to do right now. We're hopeful that the funding will come through for it.
Really, as long as the community needs us, you know, we're prepared to scale our situation as necessary to support the citizens of this area.
It's hard to predict the future, but I think we've got enough scalability here that we're good for quite a while. We have actually been doing drive-up testing out of our emergency department, which the initial positives that resulted in this case were drive-up testing. So we got a lot of the kinks worked out, knew what some of the issues were then, and this is just a scaling of that. But one of the reasons we chose this location is because it does have a lot of room. It's an excellent asset to use and allows us to leverage this and scale it as necessary. We will see those patients again. We ask that you go online, get the screening done so that we have an awareness of that. But we are taking care of the community. We're taking care of patients. We put our patients first. That's what we believe in, and we will take care of anyone.
Depending on whether or not there's a line, it should be about a 5-minute process from the time that you check in with the first station to the time that the test is completed.
Do you want to comment on why that is, that we're doing a lot of work in advance?
We are, and that's part of why we're requiring scheduling, so that we make sure that we have the patient labels and we have everything provided in advance, so that once the patient arrives, it's a very quick process. We provide some education, and then we move on to doing the test and getting the specimen collected, processed.